Hello, my name's John Parris of Parris Cues. A lot of people have trouble retipping their cues, and if they manage to glue the tip on successfully, they then have trouble shaping the tip after that. In this short film, we'd like to show you how we retip a cue. First, select your tip. There are many brands on the market. We tend to use Elk Master tips as standard on our cues. Now, people have a preference for soft, medium or hard, and I find to check the hardness of a tip, the best way is to actually listen to it. So if you just hold the tip close to your ear and just scratch the side of the tip, it's a bit like when you have a book and you close it tightly and scratch the side of the pages. The tighter it is, the denser it will sound. And that's the sound you're looking for. Just listen to that and it will tell you whether it's a soft, medium or hard. And you'll gradually get used to the density that you like. The tools you'll need for retipping your cue are as follows. A Stanley knife with a very sharp blade, the sharper the better, and this is for trimming the side of the tip into the side of the ferrule. A flat piece of sandpaper for sanding the back of the tip flat before gluing it on. A file to shape the tip once it's glued onto the top. Some strips of sandpaper for sanding the tip into the ferrule. A tip shaper to get the final dome on the cue. And a strip of very fine sandpaper to give the cue a final polish just around the edge of the tip and ferrule after it's shaped. The best types of glue to use are either a super glue or an epoxy resin, but with the super glue, make sure that it's a gel type super glue and not the runny watery type. With a piece of sandpaper on a flat surface, just sand the back of the tip. This gives a nice smooth clean surface to glue onto the cue. Once you have cut the old tip off, scrape across the top of the ferrule with the edge of the blade to clean off all the old glue. Apply a small amount of glue and spread this across the top of the cue. Gently place the tip on the top of the cue and make sure it is in the center. Carefully apply firm pressure to the tip, squashing it down onto the glue, making sure that the tip is still centered on the ferrule. If you are using a super glue gel, keep a constant pressure on the tip for around a minute. Leave for 10 to 15 minutes to allow for the glue to set before starting to shape it. If you are using an epoxy glue, gently release the pressure and leave the cue standing upright overnight before working on the tip. When the glue is set, turn the cue upside down and place the tip on a cutting board or scrap of wood. With a very sharp craft knife, carefully trim the tip around the ferrule using lots of small careful cuts to trim the tip as close to the side of the ferrule as possible. This will reduce the amount of sanding later and reduce the wear and tear on your ferrule. With a flat file or coarse tip shaper, roughly shape the dome on the top of your tip with a rocking motion going from the centre of the tip downwards. Look across the tip, turning the cue, making sure the tip has an even dome. Doing this reduces the side wall height of the tip and again leaves less to sand smooth into the ferrule, reducing the wear on the ferrule. With a 1 centimetre wide strip of fine sandpaper, around 320 grit, carefully smooth the edge of the tip into the ferrule, making sure not to sand the wood of the cue below the ferrule. To ensure the sandpaper does not touch the wood, pull the strip slightly upwards and away from the wood while applying pressure with the thumb. Work around the side of the ferrule and tip until it is smooth and flush. Using a curved tip shaper with a medium grit, around 240 to 320, sand from the centre of the tip to the outside in a rocking downward motion. Shape the tip to its final smooth dome. Do not sand upwards at any stage, as this pulls and tears the fibres of the tip. With a 1 centimetre strip of very fine, worn out sandpaper, sand around the side of the tip and ferrule to smooth and burnish the outside of the tip and polish the ferrule. To get the sandpaper super fine, pull it against a coarse piece of sandpaper to smooth it down. After playing with the tip for a while, it may flatten slightly and need reshaping. If so, just go through the last few stages with the tip shaper and fine sandpaper.